Welcome all in class 24 on electromagnetic theory. In this class we will discuss about transmission lines. First we will make model of transmission line in terms of resistance, inductance, capacitance and conductance. Then we will derive a general solution of voltage or current at any point of the transmission line. So basically transmission lines are medium which are used to transmit signals between two points separated by a distance. A two-wire transmission line is as represented in the slide. It basically consists of two conducting wires, each conductor having diameter d, and these two conductors are separated by distance s. The length of the transmission line is l. The transmission line is fed at one end by using a voltage source having input impedance Zs, and output is taken across another end through some load impedance ZL. Now, for the purpose of analysis of this transmission line, that is to find input impedance of the transmission line or to find voltage or to find current at any point of the transmission line, we need to model this transmission line in terms of resistance, inductor, capacitance or conductance values this transmission line holds. So as can be seen from the geometry of the transmission line that each wire of conductor has some length and diameter. So it must have some resistance R and inductance L. So in series we have a resistance R and inductance L. Since two wires of a conductor are separated by some distance S, like shown in the slide, there are two conductors which are separated by distance S and having some dielectrics between them, which is the coating of the conductors. So there must be some capacitance C between the wires. Further, two wires of conductor are separated by some dielectric which is not perfect insulator. So there must be some conductance G between the wires. So equivalent model of a transmission line can be represented as that it contains resistance and inductance in series with the propagation of the signal, and it consists of conductance and capacitance in between two conductors. So now here R represents the resistance of both conductors per unit length. L here represents inductance of both conductors per unit length. C here represents capacitance of both conductors per unit length. And G here represents shunt conductance of both conductors per unit length. So this unit structure consisting of R, L, G and C is repeated throughout the transmission line. That is, for each unit of the transmission line, the resistance, inductance, capacitance and conductance holds the same values. Now, from the general model of the transmission line, we have observed that it consists of series impedance, which is here is R plus j omega L, and it consists of shunt conductance, which is G plus j omega C. So, as signal propagates from one point to the another point, there is change in voltage as well as change in current due to these series and shunt impedances. Now, our aim is to calculate the voltage or current at some point of the transmission line when signal propagates from one point to the second point. In order to find the general solution of voltage or current at any point of the transmission line, consider we have a transmission line of length dx. The voltage applied at the input, that is at point P, is V, and the current generated due to the applied voltage V is I at point P. When signal propagates some distance dx, then there happens change in voltage V plus dV and change in current I plus dI. So basically we have to find that how much voltage is present at Q, and we have to find voltage or current at point Q with respect to distance x. So consider a transmission line of infinite length dx. The impedance offered by resistance in length dx is R multiplied by distance, which here is dx, because R was the resistance per unit length. So for a length of dx, the total resistance is R dx. Similarly, impedance offered by inductor in length dx is j omega L into dx, because impedance offered by an inductor L is j omega L. Similarly, admittance offered by shunt resistance in length dx is j dx. Similarly, admittance offered by shunt capacitor in length dx is j omega C into dx. Now, due to series impedance of R dx plus j omega L dx, a voltage drop of dV is experienced at point Q, which can be expressed as dV is equal to minus series impedance, which is R plus j omega L into dx, multiplied by the current in the transmission line. So from here we find that rate of change of voltage with distance is minus of R plus j omega L into I. Similarly, due to shunt admittance, the shunt admittance was of value G plus j omega C into dx, a current change of dI is experienced at point Q, which can be expressed as dI is equal to minus G plus j omega C dx into V, because expression of current is I is equal to V upon R, or 1 upon R is conductance, and the conductance of series connection, conductance of parallel connection here is G plus j omega C into dx. Or from here we find that rate of change of current with distance is minus G plus j omega C into V. Now, by using dv upon dx, if we take its double differentiation, that is d2v upon dx square, it will be equal to minus r plus j omega l into di upon dx, because r and l and omega are constants, so there is no use of taking differentiation of r j omega l with respect to distance, because these quantities are taken as constant for a transmission line. So ultimately we obtain that d2v upon dx square is equal to minus r plus j omega l into di upon dx. Now, substituting the value of di upon dx in equation 3 from equation 2, we obtain that d2v upon dx square is equal to r plus j omega l into g plus j omega c into v, which we are writing as d2v upon dx square is equal to p square into v. In a similar way, we can obtain that d2i upon dx square is equal to p square into I. So again, p here is a constant, which is the square root of r plus j omega l into g plus j omega c. The quantity p is called the propagation constant, and it can be represented as alpha plus j beta, where alpha represents the attenuation constant of the transmission line, that is, it is the attenuation per unit length when signal propagates from one point to the another point. Similarly, beta here represents the phase shift constant, which represents the change in phase of the signal when signal propagates from one point to the another point of the transmission line per unit length. Now, these are two equations, two differential equations, whose general solution is that v is equal to a e raised to power minus px plus b e raised to power px, or I is equal to c e raised to power minus px plus d e raised to power px. So by knowing the propagation constant and by knowing the distance, we can find the values of voltage by knowing the values of constant A and constant B. Similarly, we can find I by using C e raised to power minus Px plus D into e raised to power Px. Once a transmission line is given, then by calculating the voltages at the input and at the extreme end, we can calculate the values of constant A and B. And once we know the value of constant A and constant B, similarly, by knowing the value of constant C and D, we can calculate the voltage at any point of the transmission line. So this is all that we want to discuss in this class. Thank you very much.